Hey, last week I published a blog post about the conference, the computer science conference, which we managed to organize, and it happened just about a month ago. And the blog post I published just last week. So I decided to record a video explaining you my my experience, actually sharing with you what I found out for myself after this project, which took about 1 year. So we started to prepare this conference about a year ago, and the whole year was spent on actually managing this, putting this all the pieces together. I was opening the conference with a quite small speech, about 15 minutes, explaining to the audience who were listening what exactly was done and what were the biggest challenges for us at this conference. I can recap it again and emphasize the most important points. So there were a number of problems, a number of challenges which we met during this year. And let me remind you that it is a computer science conference, not an industry conference, but a computer science. It's academic conference. It's a big difference between these two types of conferences. The first one, which is industry professional conference, is where people come from different, let's say we're talking about software development, and these people coming from different companies, different places, and they share something that they do in their projects, and they tell the audience, usually something new, something interesting, some sharing some experience, maybe teaching the audience. In most cases, they don't have to prove what they say. They don't have to be scientifically valid. And I will get to this point a few minutes later today. But they need to just share what they have to share. This is professional conference, and I participated in many of those conferences and I enjoyed them. But this time we decided to organize a computer science, an academic conference, which is supposed to be completely different. And how different I will explain now, but first again let me emphasize what were the most difficult parts for us. So the first one was how to get together a so-called program committee. A program committee are the people who are supposed to read the papers, and in a academic conference, people who participate there, the authors, they're supposed to submit a full paper. It's usually 10 pages or 12, 15 pages, like a full big paper where you explain your idea. And I will get to this point a little bit later. So that was our first biggest challenge, how to get together these people, this program committee, who do this work for free. So they're supposed to read the papers, they're supposed to give their opinion about those papers, and most of the papers supposed to be rejected. So how to get these people together? So we did it. I mean, that was a very challenging task. The second challenge was how to get support of IEEE. So there are a number of large non-profit organizations in the world which support science. They help people to publish their work. If they do scientific work, scientific research, then these organizations, they help these people share their ideas in a more or less organized way. So there's ACM, Associations for Computer Machinery, and there's IEEE, and there are a few much smaller, but basically there are two giant organizations, ACM and IEEE, and they are probably like 70 or maybe up to 100 years old. So we got a support from IEEE. That was a challenging task, to convince them that our conference will actually follow the standards of the industry. So we will do the proper review of papers. We will reject bad papers. We will, and so on and so forth. So there are many regulations which we need to promise them that we're going to follow, and then we actually had to follow them. That was the second problem. And the problem number three was actually to get papers. So who will send the materials? Who will send their research to us so that we publish that research? And we managed to do that as well. We got some papers. Some of them were pretty good. Some of them were not good enough. But we managed to do it. You can read the blog post. In the blog post, I explained how exactly we did that, like step by step. This video is not about that. It's not about the preparation of the conference. I want to say that according to what I've seen, according to the journey I participated in, I more or less understood what is science. So how science works right now. It is, in my opinion, what I have right now, it is much less complicated than I thought. And maybe for you as well. So maybe you think that science is something that you shouldn't participate in because it's something complex and you better do your programming and focus on Java coding, and science is for somebody who is a completely different league, and these people are professors, crazy scientists, and not for you. It's not the case. It's not true. Science is basically, it is organized as paper writing process. So you do some work, you do something which you do on a daily basis. So you code, you write code, you implement something, you resolve some problems in your daily life, in your life, in professional life. And then when you decide to make science out of it, then you need to present your results in a way that it will look like science, in a way that it will look like a scientific research. And scientific research, it's a pretty well-defined formal process, like a well-defined, well-structured process. And for people who review your papers, and this is how it's organized in all conferences, not only our conference, but in all of them, there is a committee, there is a program committee or technical committee of people who are, you know, checking your papers, and they give their opinion. And if their opinion, they give the opinions which are positive, then your paper gets published and boom, you're the scientist. So you take your research, you take your problem which you work on, you turn this problem into a research, then you explain your results in the way that it's convenient to read, it's in a traditional way, in a way which is usual for scientists. And then the program committee will say, yeah, that's a good research, and they accept your paper. In most cases, as I can tell, they don't pay so much attention to real value or the real, the importance of your contribution, but they pay more attention to how you format your research. So you can take a problem which is not so important to the world, maybe something which is minor, but still, if you explain your results in the right way, then it will get published. And if it's published, you're the scientist. So the final goal is to publish the paper. And the paper has to be structured as far as I understand right now, after looking at how papers were reviewed and what were the comments, is that first you need to claim the problem in your paper. So you need to explain your so-called research question. So you can say something is unclear and I would love to know how it works. Then you say a few words about how this problem was solved, or how people tried to solve it before. You can say people tried to solve some relative problems, but they didn't solve my problem. Then you introduce the method of solving the problem, of answering this research question. And you introduce the method of how you're going to answer this question. Then you present your results of how you collected the results following your methodology of solving the research question. And then you conclude with some conclusions. So you say that, you know, after collecting the data, after the analysis we did, then this is the conclusion we have. And that's pretty much it. Well, in most cases, there are other approaches to scientific papers, but this is more or less traditional one. There's a research question to answer. There's a methodology to answer this question. These are the results we collected. Here's the conclusion. And if you follow this procedure, then you can easily get, well, more or less easily, get published on a computer science conference of different level. Of course, the conferences which, you know, accept hundreds of papers and they publish only a few of them, then of course they will pay attention to the importance of the problem you solve. So whether your research question is actually valuable to the industry. But on a mid-sized conferences or small conferences like we did, then, you know, we pay less attention to the core problem you solve, but more attention to how you format your results, how you present them. If you present them in the formal way, so we can repeat your methodology and receive the same results, we can follow your logic and start from your question and finish with the conclusion, then this is science. So this is all science is. It is not so far away from the coding, from writing code, from solving practical questions. Just every time you solve a practical question, try to find some generic research question which has to start in general. How is this possible? How this should work, or how this may work, or how this is related to that, in general. So you solve practical problem, but you can derive a more generic question from your practical work. With this video, I try to encourage you to think about yourself. If you are a professional developer, think about yourself. Maybe you can become, at the same time, a researcher. At the same time, you may contribute to your profile, to your CV, with an article published somewhere, maybe on our conference, a little bit of promotion. Think about it. We're going to organize the conference next year, so you can submit your paper to us as well. Think about it for your career. So maybe you can not only be a programmer, but at the same time, try yourself as a researcher. Try it out. Thanks for listening. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.